to see you. Mayor, bring it in. So how the hell have you been? Good, for the most part, I hope. Yeah? Alright, well, we'll catch up just a moment. If you don't mind, I really wasn't expecting anyone, but thanks a lot for joining me. I guess I'm just about to have my lunch. So, you know, if you don't have anything better to do or more important to do, feel free to hang out. I'd love to have you. I mean, how long has it been now? A few hours? A couple days? Months? Years? Decades? Centuries? Millennia? You'll have to forgive me. It's hard for me to keep track of time. But, yeah, so, well, I'm just about to unpack my lunch, so you wanna stick around and I'm gonna do that and eat it, and maybe we'll talk a little bit. Sound good? Alright. Alright, just see what we got. Must be completely exhausted from just standing around for how long as it did, holding all of my nutrients inside. It's a good bag. Anyway, yeah, I don't know. I like cold beverages, but I don't like it when they're so cold. It's just uncomfortable. Does that make sense? No? Okay, just me then. Anyway, we'll get to the bottle cap sound, I promise. Let's see what else we have in here. Chiquita banana, no less, which means always have to do this. It's like a tradition. Right? I mean, I'm sure you've done this, right? Stick it onto somebody else, maybe. Your siblings, your kids, co-workers, right? So, just leave that there for a little bit. A banana. So, let's get to the good stuff. Now, I feel like you can listen to that. You like that? You want to hear some more of that? Sure. Anything for you, my friend. I think the stickiness is kind of wearing out. Man, I don't want to be an advertisement for Chiquita bananas either. The creme de la creme, no pun intended. The devil dog. Now I wasn't really quite sure what to pack, what kind of treat, sweet to pack with my lunch, you know. Devil dog, maybe a crimpet. Like, do they still make crimpets? Maybe they don't. You might not understand some of these things if you're not from the United States, but this is like a chocolate cake, firm with a cream vanilla filling. So they call it Devil Dog, right? Side. Thank you. Brown bag, paper bag. You can go ahead and go about your business. There it goes. Running off. Cute. Anyway. The sandwich. Bologna and cheese. I wasn't quite sure what kind of sandwich I was going to have. I actually asked for B&B loaf, which is pickle and pimento, but believe it or not, they didn't have any of that. And it's kind of not a surprise. I mean, bologna, B&B loaf, it's cheap, but not the greatest thing for you. I mean, what kind of meat actually is this? You know, because you think about it, you want to hear a little more of those sounds. Sandwich out of the bag. bag opened. I'm probably just gonna dump these out. You know what? Hey, brown bag, where are you? Come here, boy. Jumped up on the table there for you. For me. I'm gonna use that brown bag as a makeshift little eating area, because I'm eating actually on a, just a piece of a wooden crate. See any of this. It's just, let me just adjust. All right, can you see all this a little bit better? All right. Okay, just pull the table a little bit towards me. All right, I think I spent enough time to get into it. My manners. I forgot to ask. What are you having to eat? Oh, that looks good. You wanna switch? Yeah, I already took a couple bites out. We should have, I guess, compared our lunches probably beforehand. I'm kind of jealous, I gotta say. Tell you what, as horrible as bologna may be when it comes to being a food, it's so good. This is how I used to eat for like about 30 years of my life. Brown bag, sandwich every day at school, Catholic school. High school, almost every day, and the grade school that I went to was both elementary and middle school, so K through 8, and there was no hot lunches served, I think there was hot food served in high school, but I couldn't really afford it. Not that our family was poor, but I just don't remember what they served. I know they had fries or cheese fries. I can't remember after that. And then all the different jobs I had, I would, you know, still brown bag it. I really didn't start eating out for lunch until like I made it a decent enough income. And that was like till my 30s when I started to make like a $30,000 a year job with customer service, for example, was one of the jobs I had. And I still didn't eat out every day. It's expensive and it's not good for you. There's not a lot of quick, fast, healthy alternatives for lunch. On the occasion, certain jobs, you know, co-workers and I would, we go out for lunch and, you know, you order like a $15 lunch. But even still to this day, while I do eat out lunch a little bit more frequently, I don't really eat sandwiches anymore, but still we'll eat something prepared at home. And the occasional sandwich, roast beef. So I definitely don't eat out every day, that's for sure. So there's the history of my lunches throughout my life. Really sick at sandwiches, just ate them so much, but at this point, I'm sorry, I don't mean to talk so much, I know, but you're kind of quiet, so it's kind of hard to hold a two-way conversation, so I hope you don't mind. All right. Take a few more bites of this and maybe just talk about some different things. You know, shoot the breeze, which I don't really like doing. I think it's shooting breezes is kind of inhumane. But once in a while, I think it's all right. Thank you. as well just finish it. I love putting the chips on the sandwich. I'm a Chiquita banana, and I'm proud to say that the jingle went. And now for the devil dog, but actually I'm going to save this and the banana for the very end of our little meet up here, lunch, dinner, whatever time of the day or evening it is that you're watching this, because once I start eating these, all the sugar is going to make my mouth, all the sounds like sticky, a lot of that type of sound. So at the very end. So, just take a moment to chat, I guess, if that's all right. Just to ask you, have you been overall? You sleeping better, worse these days? Yeah. I know you're quiet, and that's fine. I mean, I can kind of see you're busy eating. So, you can just get eat. I'll do all the talking, I guess. So when it comes to sleep, for the most part, I would say, 70% of the time I've slept well, throughout my life. I've had my share of being woken up by outside noise and then finding it very difficult to fall back to sleep. It sets off the alarm, the paranoia a little bit. You know, what was that noise and all that? Even though it might have just been somebody or an animal or whatever. But what helps me, I've never really had a problem getting to sleep. What helps me is I don't watch the news. I rarely watch TV unless it's some kind of a nature. Once in a while I'll watch those veterinarian reality shows, Dr. Bull. Kind of interesting and fun a little bit. Funny. I don't watch sitcoms anymore. To me, nothing beats the old sitcoms of MASH, Cheers, Monty Python, all that. So I don't watch the news. I don't have my head filled up with all kinds of nonsense that I can't control. So what's the point of filling my head with all that stuff that's going to aggravate me? I don't listen to the radio. I don't listen to much music anymore. I don't use social media. I stopped using social media for good since December, January of 2020. So January 2020, December of 2019. Around that time is when I stopped using social media for good. When I first got onto Facebook, back around like 2007, 2008, something like that, I thought it was great. You know, oh, I can connect with old high school friends, and I did that, and, you know, building up my friends list. And then after a while, you know, you see people posting stuff, stupid stuff, and then political statements, and then it becomes aggravating. And I was like, wait a minute, why am I becoming friends with these people? And we're not even friends in real life. And so I would quit, close the account, sign back in, close it again, get aggravated, on and on. And then over the last couple years, when I had Facebook and Instagram and Twitter for my channel, I just started using it just to fuck around. I never really took it seriously. Then I just stopped using it, because it's just everything that's on social media is aggravating. You know, it's just annoying. For the most part, there are some good people out there who use it to, you know, display their art. And that's the one aspect that I did like. I love art. But that's a very small portion. The rest of people that use Facebook and Twitter, Instagram, not everyone. But, you know, the constant promotion and look at me and... and all of the political statements and stuff, and which I found myself falling into that bad habit. It's like an infection, like a virus. Social media is. And so I just had to shut that down. And I feel so much better because of it. And it's not that I don't want to have an interaction with you or anyone else, but it just, I gotta do what I gotta do for my own sanity, so I can live in reality and not in these little imaginary fake fantasy worlds, and the brain starts making up these weird scenarios and you're getting, people are aggravating and annoying. So that's that. So I sleep well. I have less anxiety. I don't worry about whatever I can't control. I focus on my life, family, you know, do the videos that I enjoy doing, that also you enjoy. You know, you might not enjoy all of them, but, you know, I like to do a little bit of everything. So, I try to cut back the fat, all the unnecessary bullshit, and to live a more as stress-free as possible of life. At least as aggravation-free as possible. You can't get rid of stress. It's unnatural. Stress is a part of every creature's existence. Just how it is, okay? But to minimize it, you know, that's what works for me. You know, no smoking, no alcohol, no TV, no radio, no news, most especially no news. Avoid the politics, avoid social media. And I am as content and happier than I've ever been in my life. I can suggest and tell you what works for me, but it's up to you to determine what's going to work for you. And for me to say, just because I don't like something, it doesn't mean it's something that's bad, what other people shouldn't use. That's arrogance. Oh, I don't like such and such video game, so you shouldn't play it. No, the fuck out of here with that mentality. Just because I don't like something, it doesn't mean that. No, that's how it is. That's just me. You and everyone else is going to have their own opinions. That's really it. I think we've been here long enough. Appreciate you hanging out. Maybe we'll do this again. You know, let me know. If you want to do another brown bag lunch together, we can. Okay? And you can pick the sandwich and all the little whatever you want me to eat. Alright? Okay. So maybe next time, Cheetos or barbecue chips. Maybe a different kind of treat. Maybe an apple. That might be kind of noisy, though. And then, iced tea or Gatorade. Whatever. Right? Okay, so I'm going to eat these. And that's going to be it. So, I'm going to eat the devil dog, at least. Okay? And then, sign off. So, again, it was great to see you. Don't be a stranger here. Okay? Right? I wish you all my best as you travel down your own path in life. I wish you all the best and luck in whatever you're trying to achieve. You know? And all that. Okay? Alright. Time for the coop degrease. Mutilated it. Anyway, that's a devil dog, in case you've never seen it. It's like this firm, cakey, however you want to describe that, nice cream filling. So, I'm gonna eat this, and I'll see you around again. So long, for now. So fucking good. This is the one good thing about being human.